So we want to find the volume of a solid with a circular base, radius 4, and whose cross sections that are squares. Now, in case you're having a hard time thinking about that, I brought a model. So here we have the circular base, right? And what we're imagining is that if we slice this perpendicular to that base, that each of those cross sections will be a square. And so here you can see all these different squares, and we get a different square depending the size of the square depends upon where we're slicing, because the width of the rectangle corresponds with the width of the circle at that point. So let's see how that works. So here is our circular base with a radius of 4, and we're imagining that a cross section or a slice is a square. In other words, if we were to take this object, and really we're thinking of this object like being like that, and if we slice it this way, then each of those slices will be a square in its cross section. So if we were to take this cross section and turn it out, we would get a square with a little bit of thickness, right? Because we're going to imagine it's taking slices of volume here. So to find the volume of this whole solid, we're going to need to find the volume of one slice and then add it up. So to do that, first thing we're going to do is introduce a coordinate system here so that we have an origin there to work with. And then we can write an equation for this circle. So x squared plus y squared equals radius squared gives me an equation for that circle. Next, I need to introduce a variable for where I am slicing. And here, it looks like the x value is giving me the location of the slice. So now, from that x value, I need to know how tall my slice is. So for that, I need to know what these y values are so I can find the height. So solving my equation here, y squared equals, let's go ahead and square that, 16 minus x squared. Y is plus or minus root 16 minus x squared. And so my y value here is the negative square root, and the y value here is the positive square root. Right? And the total height, then, is the difference between those. Or you could also think of it as this height is root 16 minus x squared. This is the same. And so this entire height will be 2 square root of 16 minus x squared. Okay? Notice that this works the way we would expect. When x is 0, then this value is going to be very large. We're going to have a total height of 8. When x gets close to 4, then this value is going to get much smaller because the slices over here are going to be much shorter. So the length of this side corresponds with this side of my slice. So this is 2 root 16 minus x squared. And because it's a square, this side has the same length. So now we can write an equation for the volume of this slice. So it's a rectangular solid. We have length 2 times root 16 minus x squared. We have height 2 times root 16 minus x squared. And we have a tiny thickness here corresponding to the thickness there, some little dx. So the volume of the slice, if we simplify this, will be 4 times 16 minus x squared, multiplying it, the square root goes away, dx. So that's the volume of any one slice here. Now we can go ahead and find the total volume of our solid by adding up all of these little slices. So we're going to integrate, we're going to add up all these little slices for x values starting at the left side, so at an x value of negative 4, coming all the way over here to an x value of 4. And this integral will give me the volume of this strange solid with a circular base and whose cross sections are squares.